Hello and welcome to this Microsoft Dynamics CRM Online training video. My name is Oliver Cox and I work in the CRM support escalation team at Microsoft. For this video in particular, we'll be looking at troubleshooting errors when viewing reports. So what we'll do is we'll take a look at the agenda here. We'll first of all cover off the learning objectives. We'll then go to look at the different types of report viewing issues that you can encounter or we commonly see. Then go on to the best practices for troubleshooting those, and also cover off, should you require to log a case with Microsoft, the kind of information we would expect you to provide in the first instance. Okay, so the learning objectives. So the first one really is to have a better understanding of the different types of report viewing issues that can occur, to know what techniques to use to troubleshoot or narrow down those report viewing issues, and also to know what information to provide to Microsoft should you need to raise a support case. So from our experience with the different types of cases we see coming in for CRM Online, these are the common report viewing issues or areas that we see. So we've got client-side issues. Could be from a browser or a machine perspective. Report design issues, typically custom reports, but not exclusively. Timeout issues and server-side issues, which is obviously our CRM Online deployment. First of all, if we take a look at client-side errors or issues, the first thing we would recommend that you do is to try running the report on different computers within your organization, be it your colleague's laptop or visit your IT department to see if there's a spare PC that you can use. Just like to eliminate it being a client's PC specific issue. Also to try with different supported browsers. So for example, you may use Chrome and you receive the issue, but have you tried with Internet Explorer? And it's best to do this to see again if we can pinpoint it to one specific browser or not. Antivirus can sometimes play a part. Some antivirus software are particularly intrusive in terms of interrogating web requests, and quite often you can put URL exclusions within the antivirus, so just another area to cover off there. And also determine if your network administrator has any client-side complexities in place in terms of internet connection. So how do you connect to the internet? Is it through a proxy server, or does your network have some group policies that restrict you performing certain actions or restrict certain traffic? So again, that is something that you can discuss with your internal IT department just to cover off that area. So moving on more to the report design side of things, quite typically we see issues with custom reports, and what we'll do here is we'll snap straight into a demo rather than going through too much PowerPoint at this point. So here I've got CRM Online. You can see I'm in my report list here. Now for this video I've created some example reports that have some somewhat contrived prepared issues just to really point out best practices for troubleshooting. Okay, so let's run this report design issue one report first. Okay, so you can see there relatively quickly I've received an error. Unfortunately it doesn't give me a great amount of detail, just tells me that an error has occurred. Now obviously I know this is a custom report and not an out-of-the-box report. So quite often if you've gone through the other scenarios we've just discussed, trying different browsers, so on and so forth, different machines, then really we could be looking at report design issue. So what we can do here is we can highlight that report, go to edit, and actually download a copy of this report RDL file. So I'll just do that and place that on my desktop. Okay. So now I have that report on my desktop. What we'll do now is run the Microsoft SQL Server data tools, which essentially is Visual Studio with the business intelligence templates available within it. This can be installed from a SQL Server CD or ISO image, or a SQL Express if you don't already have a license for SQL Server. In addition to installing this, you would need to install the CRM report authoring extensions. These are essentially extensions that we provide from the CRM team that allow you to write reports against our fetch XML data sources. So what I can do is go ahead and create a new project, and I'll choose report server project, and I'll call this test reporting. Now I've got my empty project. If I go and add an existing item and go to my desktop, that's where I saved my RDL file from when I downloaded it from CRM. If I go ahead and add that and double click, then I can see my report here. Now of course, if you are the report writer for your organization, you'll be familiar with this process. So the first thing that we typically do is come into the data source. For the purpose of our testing, we validate this is the relevant URL. If you've downloaded it from your CRM online organization, then the chances are this should be correct, but just make sure that is your unique organization name. For the credentials, to make life easier with our testing within this Visual Studio environment, I'm just going to hard code my credentials here. Accept that. Then I can go and preview my report. So we can see now that we're getting a much more meaningful error message than the one we saw within the CRM interface. So it says there the specified field does not exist in CRM. The contact entity does not contain an attribute with name typo ID. So the first place we go to look here is within our data sets, because that's essentially where we define the entities and attributes we are working with. And we can see straight away that we have got this referenced to an attribute called typo ID. Now, at one point, this may have actually been a valid attribute ID. It could be that your system customizer had created a relationship and then deleted that and recreated one with a different ID, or an attribute has been recreated. So it's not to say that it was wrong always. So what we'll do here for this example is we'll just enter a valid one. If we press the refresh field, it goes off and checks the syntax of that fetch XML. And then let's preview the report now. Okay, so the report's working now. So again, a somewhat basic example, but this is the kind of cases we've seen coming in. So really, all we did there was made sure we got the credentials to run the report from within this Visual Studio environment. We went into the data set, corrected the issue based on the error we'd seen, and that's rectified that issue. If we go back to CRM, I've got another example. If I run this report design issue 2, we'll see that the report does render. However, we have error messages occurring within the report. So what we do now, again, similar process. Let's go to edit that report. Let's download. And we'll place that on the desktop again. Go back into our Visual Studio environment. I'm going to add that RDL file. Open it up. And again, let's go to the data source. Let's validate. Yes, that's my unique organization name. Credentials, I'm just going to place these in here. Okay, so we can see the similar errors we've been getting within the CRM interface there. So what we need to make sure we do, so if we go to this view menu and show our error list, what we can see here is we've been given specific details about the errors. So okay, the first one, it says the value expression for address 1 underscore city contains an error, and it's something about date conversion. So what we can do, if we go back to the design of our layout, if we go to the properties of the report and We can find address one city within here. It highlights the said field for us. And if we take a look at the expression behind this, sure enough, we can see that we're doing a date. We're using a date function, I guess, against a string field because it's the address one city. So for whatever reason, we realize that's a mistake, shouldn't have been done like that. So we'll just correct that and add in just the relevant field reference. Now we can test this if we go in preview. And that's resolved that. We're now getting our cities showing fine. Similarly, for the error we're seeing on the chart there, again, it gives us some more detail about the error that's happening. Again, so it says the chart one contains an error, date value cannot be converted to a date. So if we look at the properties of that expression, we can see again there's a date add function being performed against the account ID, which is actually a GUID. So again, unrealistic, you wouldn't be doing that. And in fact, all we wanted to do is put our chart title here. So somewhat contrived examples, but you see the point that we can have these different errors appearing. Visual Studio is pointing these out to us and helping us resolve these issues. So to continue on the report design topic, we've seen there how the SQL Data Tools or Visual Studio, or it's sometimes called BIDS, Business Intelligence Development Studio within SQL 2008, can help us pinpoint the specific errors that are occurring with the design of our report. Now, quite often, if you have a very complicated, busy report layout, one suggestion would be to take a copy of that report, and you're unsure of specifically the areas or getting a lot of areas, what you can do is you can really take a copy of that report, remove a lot of the objects, and run the report, test the report, and troubleshoot in stages, introducing the various objects like tables and lists in stages to work through the errors to get to a point where you're happy that running within Visual Studio there are no problems. Of course, once you've done that, you need to upload the report again to CRM and test it from there to be sure it's running okay from the web client within CRM Online. So moving on to the topic of timeouts, the first question we really ask when it comes to timeouts is how long does it actually take for the error or the page to become responsive? So is this 20 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes? This is quite important information because it might give an indication as to what potential timeout limit you might be hitting. We'd also say try running the report from a different network or internet connection. So for example, if you have a laptop or even you're from your home computer, as this is CRM Online, you should be able to access from there. Test it from your home, or also test from a different machine out of business hours. Does it run then? Is there any theme to when it does work or it doesn't? And really, perhaps the best test is to run the report against a smaller set of data so we can be sure that the report runs okay, there's no design issues, and it really is a timeout issue that you're running into. Okay, so with regards to running the report against a smaller set of data, let's go back to Visual Studio and take a look. So the first example we'll take a look at here is using parameterization. So I have a sample report that we take a look at. You can see here this report's quite basic, and we've got two data sets, cases and users. If we take a look in cases, which is our main data set, you can see here that the fetch XML is referencing the incident, which is the case entity, returning a few attributes. And here we have this filter condition to say only retrieve data where the owner, or the owner ID, is in, and this at reference is to specify a parameter. So we will be passing in values via a parameter to filter this data down so we can run it against this report against a smaller set of data. Once you do that, you get this parameter created automatically, and if we take a look at that, we can see that you have a couple of options. You can hard code values with the specify values option, or you can get values from a query. So in this case, I'm getting values from a data set called users, and I'm bringing in the system user ID to pass into our main cases query. as the filter criteria. So if we take a look at the users and users data set, we can just see here it's basically pulling all users from the system, providing the user ID, the first name, last name, a full name. So when we preview this report, if we take a look, what happens is we get a drop-down list at the top. Now, for example, if I select all, this would be the same as not having any kind of filtering down of the data, so we get all of the records within the system. And perhaps that's when we're seeing the timeout. But if we just select, let's say, my limited access user, which I know I've only signed a few cases to, and run the report, this is a good way of us testing to say, okay, this works, so the design of the report would appear okay, but as soon as we start introducing more users' records, then we're hitting a timeout. So it's a good mechanism to use. The other example is using the pre-filtering. So take a look at this report. Similar report in design, it's just returning cases. But this time, instead of referencing a parameter, we use this enable pre-filtering option here within the entity reference, and we give the pre-filter parameter name of CRM underscore, and then in this case filtered incident, because it's the incident entity we're working with. What this does is it creates a parameter here that has a default value, which is some fetch XML, which integrates with our CRM platform. So to show you how this works, we'll snap back into our CRM organization where I have that report uploaded. So if I run that pre-filter sample, this time instead of going straight into rendering the report or giving us that option for the drop-down list, we get the advanced find looking interface to filter our data down. So essentially I could go to owner and I could choose equals and select one or many owners. So it's a similar approach to the parameterization, but it's using the CRM platform to help you provide those filters. And incidentally, you can change the default filter against a report by simply going to edit the default filter here. So those are two examples of how you can run a report against a smaller data set to help you find out if it is truly a timeout issue you are running into. So moving on, the other kind of errors that sometimes occur are server-side errors due to our CRM online deployment, and given the nature of those errors, that is something that we at Microsoft would need to look into for you. So that kind of moves us on to the next topic of logging a case. So if you have run through all of the previously mentioned troubleshooting steps and eliminated client-side issues or report design issues, and you feel that you are hitting a server-side issue or perhaps an issue that is out of your control, then you would need to log a case with us. When you log a case with us with regards to reporting cases, I'm going to list through some information which you can see on the slide here as well that is very important to give us from the outset to help speed up the resolution of that case. So details of the error seen and concise steps on how you reproduce the error, details of your operating system and browser types or versions, details of when the issue started happening, details of which users received this error and which users can run without error, if at all any. And so here we're also looking if you've tested or got your network, your CRM administrator to test the issue with their user. Again, it kind of eliminates any permission scenarios here. Also, to state whether the issue is a custom report or a standard report. If it is a custom report, then please let us know if this has ever worked or if it's a brand new report that you've just finished designing. And also, please attach the report RDL file or files if you've got a parent and sub-report scenario to the case, so that we can see that straight away. And again, if you suspect a timeout issue, please indicate the results of your testing when you've run the report against a smaller set of data. So the last slide, and really the closing thing I wanted to cover, was just providing some links to areas that we've covered within this video. So There's a link there to show you the CRM Online requirements, so that will give you information on the browser types and versions supported. There's an article there about enabling the pre-filtering in fetch-based reports. That's the one example we went through on how to run the report against a smaller set of data. Using parameters in reports, again another article there that guides you through that. Also a link to the SQL 2012 Express installation where you can obtain the SQL data tools. And also a link to the CRM 2013 report authoring extensions which are required in Visual Studio to be installed so that you can author fetch-based reports. So that concludes this video. Thank you very much for listening.